What's up, YouTube? This is your friendly neighborhood movie nerd back from vacation and back to give you guys everything that is going on in the world of movies and TV. And now I'm gonna get back into reviews. I've been away for a little bit, but I'm gonna get back into reviews and top 10 because I've got a lot of videos to churn out before I head away to college, because I've actually got a week and a half left here in my hometown before I head off to college. So I've got a lot of big transitions coming my way, but that is not gonna stop me from entertaining you, the people. And I'm gonna start that off with my next review for the movie that arguably is going to be one of the most decisive, not decisive, that's not the word I'm looking for, one of the most, divisive movies of the year, that's the word, divisive movies of the year so far, and that would be Kathryn Bigelow's Detroit. We are nearing the end of August, therefore we are basically out of blockbuster season, and we're actually getting into more of Oscar season, so lots to look forward to, but without further ado, this is my review for Detroit.
I need you to survive the night.
Detroit, which is directed by Kathryn Bigelow, who previously directed the two critically acclaimed multi-Oscar nominated films The Hurt Locker and Zero Dark Thirty. This time, she focuses on a time in US history that quite frankly a lot of people would like to forget. Taking place during the 1967 Detroit riots that sparked due to rising tensions between different social classes and resulted in the National Guard actually having to be sent in, the majority of this film takes place around the Algiers Motel, where a series of gunshots resulted in a police raid that ended up with three people dead and several others severely beaten. So just a little bit of history on Bigelow herself. She started out in Hollywood as yet another one of James Cameron's ex-wives, because he had a lot of those, but quite frankly, she made a big name for herself by directing massive cult hits such as Point Break, Blue Steel, Strange Days, and K-19, The Widowmaker. But in 2008, she became easily the most critically acclaimed and well-known female director when she released The Hurt Locker, which focused on PTSD in the form of Jeremy Renner's bomb defusal unit. The film won Best Picture, she won Best Director, and her writer Mark Bull won Best Original Screenplay. Then in 2012, she followed that up with yet another critically acclaimed military film, Zero Dark Thirty, which this time focused on the hunt and eventual execution of Osama bin Laden following the 9/11 attacks. Despite no major wins, the film was still nominated once again for Best Picture and Original Screenplay for Mark Bull, although Bigelow herself did not really receive a Best Director nomination. So despite Bigelow being a 65-year-old white woman directing a film about one of the worst occurrences of black oppression to hit the United States since slavery itself, she does a pretty damn good job, because this film is fantastically shot. One of the things I like the most about Hurt Locker and Zero Dark Thirty is how the handheld shooting style really makes you feel in the moment and increases the realistic element of the film, and it continues here. The opening scenes of this movie are so in the moment, you feel like you're really there when the riot breaks out, then when the motel raid happens, and finally in the courtroom where the film wraps up. And you feel like you're living and breathing these events with these characters, and it's extremely, extremely intense. Now, 2 years ago, I saw Straight Outta Compton, which was easily one of my favorite movies of 2015, primarily for the fact that it was finally a movie about black people that didn't involve black oppression in some way. So going right back to the black oppression was certainly depressing to see, because it shows a repeating trend that Hollywood refuses to let die, but after seeing this, I am very glad, because this story, in my opinion, did need to be told. The fact that this event happened, the fact of how brutal it was with both what was shown on screen and what wasn't, because there was a lot that was not shown on the screen, and the fact that it barely had any repercussions on the bureaucracy and the cops who perpetrated the event, it's rather despicable, and they show that a broken system that in 50 years is still suffering from vastly similar problems. The cast in this movie is superb, because unlike Bigelow's last two films, there is no one central player. Instead, this film focuses on several different characters, giving us different viewpoints into these events, which really helps you to give the viewer a three-dimensional viewpoint into the event. The standout performance for me here is easily the lead cop, who's played by Will Poulter from Chronicles of Narnia, Voyage of the Dawn Treader, We're the Millers, The Maze Runner, and The Revenant, and he is easily the best he has ever been in this movie. Everyone who saw the trailer knew that he was going to be the despicable racist cop in this movie, but the thing that made him even more despicable in this movie is the fact that up until the actual motel shooting scene, all of his actions are rationalized. Everything he says makes sense because the way the first 10 minutes of the movie are shot, all the cop's actions are rationalized, which makes it even more terrifying when he finally goes all out racist at the motel, because it shows what a calculating type of person he is, which ultimately makes for the most terrifying type of movie monster. The one that knows he's one, but doesn't care because he can rationalize every one of his actions and make you at the very least understand while not necessarily agreeing with what he's doing. The rest of the cast cast is superb as well. John Boyega is in the film as Melvin Dismukes, a security guard who gets caught up in the affair, and he is fantastic and knocks it out of the park in every scene he's in. Also, two other standouts for me in this cast were Algie Smith and Jacob Lattimore, who played Larry Reed and Fred Temple, the lead singer and his close friend of the Motown singing group The Dynamics, who were simply in the wrong place at the wrong time when they're caught up in the raid. Also, my girl from Game of Thrones, Hannah Murray, was in this movie as one of two white girls who actually get caught up in the raid, and she was actually pretty spectacular. I thought all her reactions to what was going on around her were on point, and she showed that she still has some serious acting chops. If I had to state any problems I have with this movie, I would say I'm just tired of movies about black oppression, but that really is outweighed by the fact that this was an important story that needed to be told. Superb direction once again from Kathryn Bigelow. Would not be surprised if this gets her another directing nomination. Extremely heightened sense of tension and violence, while disturbing, never feels over the top and gory just for the sake of being gory, making this easily one of the best films I've seen so far this year. I am giving this movie 9.5 out of 10 stars. So that was my review for Detroit. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below, and also be sure to stay tuned for the vast amount of content that I'm going to be releasing soon enough. I still have to get out my American Gods recap. Also, stay tuned soon enough for my Game of Thrones season 7 recap. I still have to churn out my season 6 one, but that is coming. Do not worry. And also be sure to click the like button, the subscribe button. Follow me on Twitter at @movienerdreview. Also, head on over to the website, movienerdreviews.com. That is it. I will see you guys next time.